Good evening and welcome to our second session on expert lecture series today by a very, very predominant person that has been doing a lot of work in the field of education. Our first day session on cyberbullying was definitely very useful for our students and the fellow colleagues. And today, as we come to the second session on Gandhiji's activity method of teaching, I'm sure it's going to be an eye-opener for all the students and for the fellow colleagues to have a deeper insight on this particular topic. Today's resource person for our second session on expert lecture series is none other than Dr. Francis Vaidya. May I introduce Dr. Francis Vaidya? Good evening, Dr. Francis Vaidya. Dr. Francis Vaidya is an associate professor at Gandhi Sikshan Bhavan's Srimati Surajbha College of Education. She has a teaching experience of over 20 years and she has completed successfully her doctoral studies in education from SNDT University. She has also completed her master's degree in philosophy in education, and she has also a lot of credentials to her credit. She has been awarded the Dr. F. G. Selby Memorial Award for securing the highest marks in all the 6 papers of philosophy. She's also been awarded the Jamnabai Govindji Madhavji Prize for PhD degree in education. She's also a distinguished educator, received an award by I2OR, International Institute of Organization Research. She's also a PhD guide from the Mumbai University. Her academic credentials are being the chairperson for various examinations at the University of Mumbai, and she is also the president of InnoWheel Society. She has a lot of credits under her credentials, but moreover, to tell about it is today is she is a true practitioner of Gandhiji's teachings, and being in Gandhi Sikshan Bhavan, I know that every faculty there has a lot of Gandhism in their spirit of Gandhism in all their activities that they take up. And today, this topic of activity method of teaching given by Gandhiji is a true way to come up with the topic, and none other than Dr. Francis Vaidya will be the right person to share her thoughts on this topic. So with a warm welcome, we call you Dr. Francis Vaidya for this wonderful session again. We are sure that you will throw light on the teachings of Gandhiji, and I'm sure all our participants and all our students will be enlightened by your talk. Over to you, Dr. Francis.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the management of Pillai's College of Education and the principal, Dr. Rennie Francis, for having me here. It's a great honor to always come to Pillai, and I always look upon at Pillai as creating something innovative, and the leader herself is absolutely a creative, innovative personality. So thank you for Dr. Rennie for having me here. I would like to start my presentation without taking much time. So as you know, Gandhiji's favorite quote, "Be the change you wish to see in the world." I'm Dr. Francis Vaidya, an associate professor of Gandhi Sikshan Bhavan, Srimati Surajbha College of Education. And the topic which I'm going to talk about is the activity method of teaching of Mahatma Gandhi. Can you have the next slide, please? Now I want to show you the outline of what I'm going to talk. A little bit of introduction, and we'll go down the memory lane with regard to the educational aspect. What was the scenario in ancient time and how it has shifted in modern time. We look at it from the concept of activity method, that is the what aspect. We will also look at it from the why aspect. Why the basis of modern child-centered education necessary? And lastly, the how aspect, that is the educational significance of activity method of education. Now, I would like you to have a look at this picture. Look at it very carefully. Where have you seen this picture? If you can type, I'll be happy to know the answers. And the next question which I would like you to know is, what does this picture convey to you? Dr. Rennie, will they type in? Textbooks. Swastidal says textbooks. Where have you seen this picture? I would like the students also to interact in rural areas, okay? Learning through games. I want to know the first question. Where have you seen this picture? It's a very familiar picture. I want you to know, where have you seen? In rural areas? Anybody else? This is a picture on the cover page of the draft policy, National Education Policy of 2019. Very good, very nice. Aganwadi, very good. Gayatri, excellent. Balwadi School. What does this picture convey to you? What does it convey to you? Rural area, okay, go ahead. Something different. Look at the picture very carefully. Look at the scenario. You said it is rural area. So you think that Gandhiji wanted a rural immersion. What else do you see in this picture? A village, okay, a school, very good. What are the school children doing in the school? Think. Do you see them doing anything or are they in the classrooms? Unity. What is the little boy in the blue shirt doing? Do you think he is doing some activity? Do you think he is trying to learn on his own? Learning through nature? Very good. What else? You can see the big boy and someone is helping him. Now they have electronics, so they're giving importance to activities, very good. They're giving importance to technology. He's arranging marbles, very good. Very, very nice. Can we have the next slide, please? Very good. Learning on the basis of child development, like a small child, then by objects for young ones, from books, concept teaching. Very good, Gayatri, good try. Let's see, that picture was of the new educational policy 2020, but that picture was on the cover page of the draft of 2019 National Education Policy. And why was that there? Why was the boy learning to play? At this 21st century, we are talking about activity. What was the rationale that this picture had to be? Was there something lacking in the educational system? Yes. As you know, that subjects were all taught in watertight compartments. What do I mean by watertight compartments? We learned history, geography, English, Marathi, geography, maths, everything in different sections. We did not know the relationship between each subject. Were they related? Subjects were taught for the sake of that subject. It was compartmentalized. There were different compartments. And the education system of the earlier time enabled us to face the challenges of life. I remember my day when I passed the 10th. It was very difficult for me. I knew there were three streams, arts, science, commerce. But I did not know what was it. There was no orientation. I never was aware of where it would take me to. The education, I had the qualification of passing 10th standard, but it did not prepare me for any skill. On the other hand, it also did not prepare me for life or the social skill. I just listened to the teacher and listened at her, looked at her. I had many queries in my mind to ask the teacher. I was scared because the teacher was regarded as the guru. It was not learner-centered. And therefore, there is also a dire need to change the educational system. During Gandhiji's time, he said, it has to be restructured. It has to reach the lives of the people. It has to be reach the social aspect of the people. It has to be revamped. It has to be revitalized and reorganized as per the needs of the society. When I finish my education, I need to be an asset to the society. I need to give back to the society. But this type of education was not allowing me to do because I have no skills. Gandhiji was not for the Western type of education. And he wanted that education where Indians would take pride. We have now our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who have said, make in India products. And how beautiful. He has tried to bring back Gandhiji's concept of education. And that was Nayi Taleem. Very good. Rajinder, there was a paradigm shift from teacher-centered to learner-centered to experience-centered. That's absolutely correct. Yes. Can we have the next slide, please? So let's see what is this Nayi Taleem. Let's see the concept of education as per what was Gandhiji's view. And so we look at the next picture. Everything was not as per the needs of the society, what do you think this picture would depict? You can put in your chat box, what do you think this picture depicts to you? Do you think there is anything different from one the snail to the other? Very good. Bunyadi Siksha. Very good. Siksha. Shika. But what answer the question, what does this picture depict to you? What does this picture tell you? Is there any difference between the snail? I think yes. That one snail is leading the change. And he's trying to tell us, be the change you wish to see in the world. Our educational system is not revamped, restructured, revitalized, it will not prepare us for the society to live in. And therefore, this little snail is telling us, come on, wake up, get up. It's time to change our educational system, needs a paradigm shift. Yes. So let's look at the paradigm shift. We had a monodisciplinary, and now we are changing into multidisciplinary. Be unique. Very good, Mel. You said it correctly. It came a little bit later. Do something different from one another. We all are the same, but we should know our capabilities. Excellent, Anushree. So disciplinary from monodisciplinary, it becomes multidisciplinary. So from teacher-centered, it is student-centered. Yes, we need to think. Snail is flying. We need to think out of the box. Very good. It's trying to do something different. It's trying to be unique. Excellent, students. So some snails are following the crowd. Absolutely. We need to be lead the change. That is what that slave. And earlier, the learning was very fragmented. As I told you, each was taught in watertight compartments. And instruction, the teacher was the main giver of instructions. That was a traditional way of teaching, where we regarded the teacher as the guru. And we respected the teacher, and we did not question the teacher. Slowly, the educational system started to change to make it student-centered. And when it became student-centered, there was a shift from teacher-centered education to student-centered education. And that makes a large difference. Let's see how learning can be fun when we make the students learn. They start using their own ideas. They start constructing their own ideas. And of course, as there is a need for computer, technology is advancing. So computer technology, the pandemic situation, is the best teacher who has made us to learn the online teaching. So there is a paradigm shift from teacher education, teacher-centered education, where the teacher was regarded the sage on the stage. Now the role is shifted to guide by the side. The teacher is now the facilitator, the mentor, the provider of situation. And we also have change in the network knowing, which was interdisciplinary, prescriptive, and now we are integrating learning, and we have cloud computing too. Next, please. Let's see. I'm sure that all of you know the definition of Gandhiji. What he said by education, I mean drawing out the best in child and mind, mind, body, and spirit. What are we drawing out? What is the best in child and man? What are the domains which are being used? Where is the mind? Is it connected with knowledge? What's the body? Is it connected in doing? And the spirit? Is it connected with the effective domain? So Gandhiji was talking about the holistic development of personality. He wanted the person to know, to do, and to understand, and also to bring about values in them. This is what he thought, that education would be best for a child and man. And he said that so many years ago, but till today, we are still talking about this. What Gandhiji had spoken is now come into the NEP 2020. It's come into the policy, educational policy of 2020. Next, please. He speaks about Nayi Taleem. Now, let's look at what is Nayi Taleem? Yes, ma'am. What do you think would be Nayi Taleem? Education, according to Gandhiji, should be self-supporting. What do you mean by self-supporting? It should make the man stand on his own feet. There is a very nice tagline he used to use: earn while you learn and learn while you earn. So what education you get? I'm sure you all have SUPW in your socially, usefully productive work. You make so many things by your hand, and that is providing you skills. It helps you that tomorrow you can be a small entrepreneur with whatever you have learned, maybe jute work, maybe apron, maybe mehndi, maybe gardening, maybe microgreens, anything. So his focus was on craft-centered education. He wanted to go back to the rural areas where people believed in making small baskets and sell it to the market and earn, where people were self-sufficient at that time. He wanted that education which was of good moral value. He feels that today values are diminishing. And that is the most sought commodity today. Culture, we need to preserve, transmit, and disseminate our culture. So therefore, he speaks of education of the philosophical, the psychological, the sociological aspect of it. Yes, very good. The mental cell is also an important role for experiential learning. Very good. Dignity of labor. How many of us, if I ask you today, would pick up a broom and sweep? Maybe mommy shouts. Today, young generation is hardly want to pick up the dustbin or the broom to sweep. And Gandhiji was a self-made man. He used to do his work himself. He was a role model to the society. So in order to he practiced what he preached. And therefore, the next slide, please. For him, he speaks about this. Look at the picture. He speaks about basic education. For him, the basic education links the children, whether it is city or the villages, to all that is best and lasting in India. And the make in India fits very well into the basic concept of education, the basic education. Why do we need to buy things from outside? Are we not self-made, self-sufficient? Do we need to have foreign products? We are the ones going abroad and making their name famous. He pleads to the people, be in your own country. Do your work in your own country and make your country proud of you. So for him, basic education or Bunyadi Shikshan, as we say, is what we will see next. Nai, as we all know, is new. And in the Urdu meaning of the word talim is education. So he wanted a new type of education, which somebody rightly said in the chat that it is Bunyadi Shiksha or basic education. And if you look at these pictures, this is a when we were in practice teaching school, this is a picture where what the students are doing. The student teacher has taught the concept and now they are doing it by the hand. They have made the craft. I think they were talking about the scale of the weighing scale and they are trying to make it by themselves. So education focuses on the head, heart, and the hand. And it believes that all are inseparable. The three H, the head, heart, and hand go in sync with each other. There is a relationship between work and intelligence. In this process of doing work by yourself, You are developing individually and personally, and there is interdevelopment, intrapersonal development of the student, which will further lead to social development. Look at Gandhiji. He's doing his work alone. Such a great man, but he believed in doing work by himself. It insists, we continue with Nayi Taleem, it insists that we do work, learning by doing, and use an integrated approach. What do you mean by integrated approach? The concepts which are taught, you can use drama, I'm sure Pillai's College is doing it under the real great leadership of Dr. Rennie. She's a very, very innovative, and she's very passionate about trying new things. And she believes in doing things every day. There is something or the other come up in Pillai's College and something really innovative. This lecture series is also her baby idea, which is so innovative. I'm teaching my students also, and it can be learned by all. So if there is an integrated approach, you are learning, you are doing, and you are at the same time hearing. Suppose you are talking about social reformers. So what do we do is that my battery was going low. So if you're talking about social reformers, maybe you could sing up a nice little song on social reformers, or maybe you could sing a song of Hum Honge Kamyab if you're doing community work. This brings out when the child is learning by doing, the child explores. See, they are all busy. They are all very busy with their own work. They are not bothered. They are learning by themselves. There's a little bit of disturbance here. They might be talking, but that is okay. That is fine. They are disciplining themselves. They are self-disciplined. This allows the children to explore. They might make mistakes. They might be making mistakes. They might not be doing it correctly. Let it happen. In this process, they are refining. They are presenting their ideas. Each one comes out with something new, better than the other. And here, when you see someone doesn't have a ruler, a scale, a scissors, they give each other, and that builds in community togetherness, cohesiveness. They like each other. They love each other. Values of love, cooperation, community awareness comes together, and that is what Gandhiji wanted in education. Next. I have made a multi-dimensional integrated approach of Gandhian model. On one hand, we have a curricular aspect. On the other hand, we have the co-curricular aspect. They can be interchanged. You can make games your curricular aspect also a part of your teaching. So that is why the double arrow, it can be interchange. You can have, for example, if I'm teaching knowledge and curriculum, I'm teaching different, the John Dewey, Gandhiji, and Paulo Freire, as you have in your syllabus. I can have a group discussion. I can have one on having the concept of Nayi Taleem. One, I can have the need for Nayi Taleem. One, I can have the educational significance of Nayi Taleem. I can divide the students into groups, and they are going to give them the reference, and they are all going to discuss among themselves. So beautiful. Learning is no longer for me to come into class and to teach. You are learning yourself. Your mind is not a tabula rasa. It is going to come out. You're going to share your experiences. You're going to listen to your friends. And that is going to bring about new ideas. That brings in active learning. We are no longer passive learners. We no longer refer this as the students as passive listeners. So we have another curricular aspect where I'm sure you are doing it in your practice teaching. You have taught to role play, to drama, to self-study, to group discussion, to 70s constructivism, and what have you. And in this process, you have narration, debates, heuristic approach, where the child is placed in the form of discoverer. You are inquiry-based learning. You are putting forward, you are a facilitator of knowledge, and the child is learning critical thinking, logical thinking. They are being imaginative, innovative. So Gandhiji believes that let the child be the center of education. Let him explore. He was an idealist. He was a naturalist. He was a pragmatist. If you don't know these words, the very word pragmatist comes being practical. Naturalist comes from being nature. So he said, let the children do what they want. Go give them the opportunity. Provide them as per their capability. Come out and they will speak out. So when you have group discussion, it is compulsory for all to speak. The students who are shy, come start talking, and teachers love it. So it comes out of their shell. On the other hand, we have games. We have you have a beautiful game. I have planned you a game, a quiz. I hope it works. If it doesn't work, I'm so sorry about it. Let's try out a game on this. We have aesthetic development. You know that when you go and watch, you go for visits, you go for field visits, you go to a post office, you go to a fish market, you will see, you learn so many things. If you go to caves, when we look at the caves, we do not know. But let the children go and become aesthetic in their development. Let them go and see the beautiful museums which we have, and let them learn. Education should be need-based, whatever the society needs. We are democratic, so we need them to lead to democracy, teach them to democracy. For example, if I want to teach the concept of democracy, I am not going to say, oh, by Abraham Lincoln, it is democracy for the people, of the people, by the people. I'm not going to say that. I might say, students, let's go for a picnic. Would you like to go for a picnic? And everybody says, yes, I would like to go for a picnic. Okay, tell me, where would you like to go for the picnic after the COVID, not now, okay? So where would you like to go for the picnic? And somebody would say, Lonavala, Mathuran, and all the people, all the students are bubbling because they're thinking they're going for the picnic. Okay, how many days would you like to go for the picnic? Miss one night, miss two nights, or let's go for three, we'll be away. We're tired being from exam. Okay, how much would you like to pay for the picnic? 1,000, 2,000, 500, lunch and all free in a good hotel, not a five-star. So you're asking all questions. Then I would say, which date would you prefer? They would say, ma'am, after the COVID. So I said, okay. So I asked them, who decided to go for the picnic? I asked you a question. You all decided. You decided the date. You decided the place. You decided the money. And everything is done by you. And that is what is called democracy. This builds in inquiry base, and it is a need, because we need democratic people. this all types of curricular and co-curricular activities which can be interlinked, interwoven into the curriculum brings about a harmonious, progressive development, as Pestalozzi rightly said. And as John Dewey said, it helps to continuous reconstruction of experiences. So all John Dewey also believed in learning by doing. And same way Gandhiji speaks about it. In self, when we are learning in this, we get all these types of learning, and learning can be fun.
I think Dr. Francis is having some network issue. Nevertheless, she'll be joining us very soon. The session that Dr. Francis was talking about, the Gandhi the model of multidimensional model, I had attended her presentation in one of the international conferences, where this particular model was presented, and it was highly appreciated because of the main focus on, we are not just talking about curricular activities, but we are also intertwining it with the co-curricular activities. Because we have heard this, all work makes Jack a dull boy. If you are going to give only academics to the children all the day, then they're not going to be talking about, you know, development of, we always say that, as teachers, we should focus on all-round development or holistic development. So where does holistic or all-round development come in? When you are really going to develop all their senses. So when we speak about all-round development, we speak about physical development, we speak about intellectual development, we speak about spiritual development, we speak about social development, we speak about cultural development, we speak about ethical development, moral development. All these development is a part of our learning process. And if we are just going to focus on academics all throughout, then this particular aspect of holistic development cannot be taken in, will not be seen. And hence, the particular model that Dr. Francis mentioned about, that is the multidimensional model, which spoke about both the aspects of curricular as well as co-curricular activities. That's when you are involving the student in the learning process. As Gandhiji's definition on education says that by education, Gandhiji means the all-round drawing out. So you are here as a teacher, you are trying to draw out, you are trying to bring out what? What are you trying to bring out? The best. So as a teacher, you need to identify what is the best. And when you start looking at it very carefully, that's when you'll be able to understand the best. Yes, we have Dr. Francis back again with us.
Dr. Remy. So we have something common. I'm sure that if one Francis goes, the other Francis will be there. Thank you for always supporting me, Dr. Remy. So I was continuing with this, that we have SUPW in college. We have socially useful productive work, and the students at this age also are being changed into student-centered activity. And you see, when they make certain things, it comes naturally. Their talents are shown and they seem interested and engaged. So the three H's are used to the fullest. Next. These are the activities done by our students when we had the practice teaching online, no, offline. We had this where the students made use of, this is the school, and they made the best out of waste, and they put it into the in the garden, and they were so proud of it. Every day they would go and see whether their plants have grown. They made beautiful folders, best of the waste. One of the most important thing which Gandhiji said is learning through mother tongue. Why mother tongue? I'm really surprised that to see little children speak their mother tongue so beautifully. And Gandhiji says, learn through mother tongue. Be proud of your mother tongue. We have students in B.Ed. colleges who want to write in English. They do not want to learn to write in their mother tongue if they want, or their language which is most appropriate for them. But it plays an important role that you use your mother tongue and propagate it. If you use your mother tongue, learn through mother tongue, I'm sure you will be an absolutely capable person, because we have seen students failing because they have written in English. They are all great students, but they insist on not writing in Hindi or Marathi, and therefore they be a failure. So don't feel shy to speak in your mother tongue and learn your mother tongue. Be proud of it. Next. So now we come to the needs of the activity method. As you see, we have all gone through it. It is necessary for the activity method. In short, we will say that it brings about attention, it engages student, it is child-centered, they are become innovative, they develop vocational skill, life skill, social skill, and makes learning a joyful, a meaningful journey. The values are also developed through it. Have a look. Gandhiji washed his own clothes. He did not want anyone to do. So please try to do the little you have. Help your mom now, because you have, this is the time where you can learn. And even in B.Ed., we have many assignments, projects, reflective journals, where you reflect on it and you are doing your work, so you will retain your work knowledge better and you can answer your MCQs, I am sure. Next. What are the educational implications? As we say that Nayi Taalim, knowledge and work, are the two sides of the same coin. Okay, it caters to all three domains. Constructivism, as Plato said, mind is a tabula rasa. We are not a tabula rasa, not an empty slate. The child comes with some knowledge based on his past experience, based on the past knowledge, and therefore it is important for the teacher to be the facilitator of knowledge. She is a mentor. She has to foster life skills, soft skills, provide real life experience, and the real life experience has to be understood and applied to the life. So it becomes a holistic development. Next, please. Yes. Now I request Sangeeta, if you can play the game. Sangeeta, if it is possible. Okay, I think she's not there. Now, what I want to do in 2-3 minutes, let me see if you can spot out as many words as you can, which you feel is important and has brought change in your life, and you will bring with for Mahatma Gandhi. Your time starts now. You can put it on the chat box. Look at the words which you can find with related to Mahatma Gandhi. Very good. Come on, let's see. only courage, peace in life, mind and body. Okay, looking at the picture, look at the picture. Peace, very good. Try to get the smaller words. What else he talks? Non-violence, very good. There are so many words. Negotiation, very good, Darshana. Benevolence, excellent, Naisa. Come on. Peace, Heli, yes. Respect. Teachers, you must learn your spellings. Inclusion, very good. There's something more which we spoke about. Transformation, very good, Naisa. Inclusion, passion, dignity, respect, liberation, very good. Negotiation, there are many more. Compassion, excellent. Creativity, honesty, solidarity, mindfulness, very good. Dr. Rennie, your students are excellent. Mindfulness. There are smaller words. Let's see whether you can find it. With regard to society, see what you can get with regard to society. Honesty, reconciliation, okay. What with regard to society? Anything with community? Anybody can, sincerity, anybody can spot out community? Very good. Is there anywhere friendship? Is there anywhere education? Wow, mother, father, friendship. Yes, Lysandra. Grief, no, wow, wow. Very good. So we have, you can see, he's surrounded. The halo is not only on the top. He's a role model for us in education. As teachers, we must lead the change. We must bring about this transformation. We must encourage dignity of labor. We must see that there is no violence with perseverance. And all this is possible through education. Thank you so much. This is the reference which I have. I'm so sorry I got locked out. But it happens. Education is all adjustment. And it is so beautiful that someone takes over and the show must go on. So thank you, Dr. Rennie, for having me here. Thank you so much. Any questions would you like to ask me?
Yes, we have asked. Students can now post their queries, questions. This is a great opportunity that you have. A person who has really dealt with each and every aspect so clearly, the concept clarity is too good. One special aspect that I would like to share about Dr. Frances is, as a person, she always believes in be the change that you can see in the world around. And that's what she drives her life through. And she's a person who has a lot of passion towards teaching and learning. She's so passionate about it, and every day she is learning so much. Every initiative that you put across to Dr. Frances, she said, let's try this. Come on, let's do it. So she's herself is so passionate. And when you are so passionate, you it's like it's a contagious disease. So you spread the passion of learning to everybody. So that is important because that's how you inspire the students and your fellow colleagues to move on and to take it up in such a manner that really it makes a difference. And yes, I should put up this quote by one of a student who will really vouch for what I am saying, that yes, she is too good and she has been always leading through example, leading by example. And she is a great motivator. There is no point of time that Dr. Frances denies any kind of support, because she helps everybody to come up. And that's the best part about learning, is you do not just go walk alone, but you take along with you the others also. And that's so important, because when you are learning, you are sharing. And when you are sharing, there is community engagement. And when there is community engagement, the whole community thrives towards the best. So it indeed, Dr. Francis, it's wonderful to have you here with us. And I know as a person, you have always been gone out of your way to do the best for everybody. So if we have any questions, we can take it up now. I feel, Dr. Francis, everything is so crystal clear. You were so patient in explaining everything to them. And that's really a remarkable thing, because today you have touched so many people live. It was only the benefit of few of your students who were there in your classroom. But today, this has extended to so many, and many more will also benefit through this online session. So do we have any more questions that we are taking it up? It's just that everybody is so happy, and that they are just on with going on saying yes, and they have it's been crystal clear to them, so I don't think they are left with any doubts.
I think you have already set the trend, ma'am, and they are learning by living through your experiences. So you are the lucky charm. And I'm sure you are yourself. We are both related in Francis, and we are both related as Gandhi. So we both lead the change in our own little ways. Thank you so much, ma'am, for having me here.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So with this, So I hope that there are no more questions coming up. With this, we can take this session as to come to an end. Dr. Francis, it's indeed a pleasure to have you here with us today. And I'm sure that we'll be able to connect with you in many other sessions for ahead also. And this would be a great learning experience for all our students across the various colleges, the B.Ed. colleges in Mumbai, as well as for others, because activity-based learning, As you explained the aspect of the integrated learning approach, and also with Ventil and other aspects, I think it's important for every student to know about experiential learning, and probably this will give us a wider experience of learning. So thank you so much, Francis. And as we come to an end, we wish you very best of success in all your future endeavors. Thank you, students, and have a great day.
Thank you.